Eucharistic celebration.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the feast of Saint Lawrence, a deacon of our Holy Church. Through his intercession, may we also be inspired in loving and seeing others with value in their littleness, in their own little ways, and in their own and also in their humble ways. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the mysteries of Christ's love, let us ask the Lord for pardon and for strength. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call the sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you. We bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Amen. Let us pray. O God, the giver of that ardor of love for you, by which Saint Lawrence was outstandingly faithful in service and glorious in martyrdom, grant that we may love what he loved and put into practice what he taught. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, whoever sows sparingly with all reaps sparingly, and whoever sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each must do as already determined, without sadness and compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. Moreover, God is able to make every grace abundant for you, so that in all things, always having all you need, you may have an abundance for every good work, as it is written. He scatters abroad, he gives to the poor, his righteousness endures forever. The one who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed and increase the harvest of your righteousness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands. His prosperity shall be mighty upon the earth. The upright generation shall be blessed.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Well for the man who is gracious and lends, who conducts his affairs with justice, he shall never move. The just one shall be in everlasting remembrance.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
An evil report he shall not fear. His heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. His heart is steadfast. He shall not fear till he looks down upon his foes.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Lavishly he gives the poor. His generosity shall endure forever. His horn shall be exalted in glory.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it, and whoever hates his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also will my servant be. The Father will honor whoever serves me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
There is this story about Saint Lawrence, the one whom we all celebrate today, when he was asked by the prefect of their city to gather and present to him the riches of the church. Alam marahil ng kanilang pinuno na sa kanilang simbahan o sa kanilang pagtitipon, mayroong mga ginto at mga magagandang bagay na kanilang ginagamit sa kanilang pagsamba. Kaya, pagkakataon na ito para kunin ito ng kanilang mga pinuno at hindi at pagnakawan sila. But to the surprise of the prefect, Lawrence presented not gold, not chalices, not the money of the church, but he presented to him the poor, those neglected by the society, by saying, "Here are the true riches of the church." Kung may kapupulutan po tayo ng aral sa santong ito, isa sa mga magagandang aral na ating mangyaring isa puso ay kung papaano siya nagpahalaga. He valued not only rich and valuable people, not only rich or valuable things. He even valued those despised and set aside by others. He saw value and richness to those seeming less valuable and rich for others. And this is what St. Paul in our first reading would like to invite us. St. Lawrence did his part by being generous to these poor men and women. There was even this story that he gave all the gold materials of their church to these poor men and women. He was a cheerful giver not only of gifts, but a cheerful giver of love and value to these people despised by others. He was a cheerful giver not only of things, but what will make others genuinely happy as well. Mga kapatid, sa panahong ito na madaming pwedeng mamaliit, pwedeng makalimot at pwedeng maging bulag na lamang sa presensya natin araw-araw, makita nawa natin sa bawat isa na kaya natin silang pahalagahan at kaya natin silang mahalin. Kaya natin din silang mabigyang saysay araw-araw sa ating buhay. How many of us can truly say to others, kahit mahina ka, kahit maliit lamang o payak lang ang iyong buhay, kahit hindi ka mayaman, kahit simple ka lang, mahalaga ka sa akin. May iba po kasi, mahalaga lang sila sa kanilang buhay. Nakakaalala lang, kapag ka mayaman ka, kapag ka ikaw ay nasa posisyon, kapag ka ikaw ay may magandang kinatatayuan sa buhay na ito, kumbaga sasabihin nila, kung hindi ka mayaman, hindi ka mahalaga, at mas lalong hindi kita mahal sa buhay na ito. But Lawrence and the Lord who loves us so much would like to say, hindi ka man minamahal, hindi ka man pinapahalagahan, para sa akin, mahalaga ka at mahal kita. Uhaw po ang mundo sa mga nagpapahalaga at nagmamahal. At sana isa tayo sa mga iyon. Kahit payak, kahit maliit, kahit minsan mahirap mahalin, kahit hindi ka mahal-mahal, pahalagahan at mahalin ng buong puso.
Please stand.
As we celebrate the feast day of a great saint of the Church of Rome, Mother of all churches, let us beseech our loving Father to grant the requests we make together in prayer. For every petition, we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the deacons of the church may be zealous in their ministry for preaching the gospel by word and example. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That there may be enough Catholic volunteers to work for the poor, communities, or nations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may value and protect our poor as real treasures of the Church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may have fortitude in times of physical pain. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our departed loved ones may enter into the promise of eternal kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in silence for our own intentions, as we also lift up to the Lord all of the prayers offered in this Mass and our prayers for one another. In a very special way, we lift up to the Lord our prayers for our Archbishop Emeritus, Gaudencio B. Cardinal Rosales, who is also thanking the Lord for the gift of life today. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, through the intercession of Saint Lawrence, your martyr, receive the intentions we bring in the name of your risen Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, beloved brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, the offerings we joyfully make on the feast day of Saint Lawrence, and grant that they become a help to our salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised, Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy, you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance, you grant firm resolve. And in their struggle, the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth, sing a new song in adoration. And we with all the hosts of angels cry out, and without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, a God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of wealth and of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonos, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve these offerings in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Nourished by these sacred gifts, we humbly implore you, Lord, that the homage of dutiful service which we render on the feast of Saint Lawrence may bring us an increase of your saving grace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As I've said, we also remember in our prayers our Archbishop Emeritus, Cardinal Gaudencio Rosales, as he celebrates his birthday today. Let us say a short prayer and ask the intercession of the Blessed Mother to pray for him and grant him the necessary graces that he would need to receive. Together, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.